We stuck to our game plan the coach had for us, you know, and we came out with another win tonight.
Agradezco una vez más a Dios por esta victoria y por la oportunidad que recibió y también que agradece al dirigente Vicky López las estrategias y el permitirle jugar y ser pieza fundamental nuevamente para el conjunto, voy a decirlo, ya tienen dos victorias consecutivas. Chris, two victories in a row, and Huellas de Siglo is now in the fight for getting in the playoffs. From now on, what is going to be the strategy in order to win more games?
The same strategy that we've been having, to go out there, follow the coach's game plan, and just play with a lot of heart and respect for each other. You know, when you go out there, man, and you just play as hard as you can and do what the coach asks you to do, you know, you're going to have a high percentage chance of winning the game. You know what I'm saying? And we got down going into the fourth quarter, I think it was by 8 points. And I told the guys, I said, we're going to win this game, man. We just got to fight it out, you know, and just play hard, man, in the fourth quarter. We got to outplay these guys. You have to want it more than those guys, man, because they got guys like Joel and Batista and those guys. Those guys play hard, man. They're hungry. So you got to be just as hungry, man. Manuel Fortuna, those guys are hungry guys. You know, they're experienced guys. So when you in a game like this, you have to outplay those guys down the stretch. We watched the game against Mauricio Baez, and we saw how they fought down the stretch of that game and went to a few overtimes and won that game because they play with a lot more heart. So we wanted to come out and do that tonight against them. So we did that, and we're just moving on to the next game tomorrow. So we got to focus on that.
Bien, le preguntamos de que cuál será la estrategia para hacer con el conjunto Huellas del Siglo, ya que tienen dos victorias en forma consecutiva. Nos dice que van a seguir jugando con la misma intensidad, discutir nuevas estrategias, ya que vieron jugar a jugadores como Joel Ramírez, Manuel Fortuna, Juan Bautista Araújo, y lo vieron jugar contra el Mauricio Báez, dando ese partidazo de calidad que tuvieron el pasado viernes. Lo vieron jugar, implementaron estrategias para con esos jugadores y para con el equipo del Varias, y ahí están los resultados, y seguirán con esa misma temática en los próximos partidos. Chris, you said that Baker Lopez, you thank Baker Lopez one more time to give you the opportunity when other teams couldn't give you the opportunity. If you had to improve something on your game, what would that be?
Man, for me, it's not even trying to improve something on my game. It's just trying to have people understand what type of person I am. You know, a lot of people, they don't want to get the time to know what type of person you are inside. Sometimes they want to go off rumors and things like that, and that's not right. You know what I'm saying? We're taught by God not to judge each other. You know what I'm saying? We're taught to, you know, learn the person for yourself. See what's inside of a person's heart. You know what I'm saying? And that's what Baker Lopez did for me. He saw what was inside of my heart. He knows I was a good person. You know, I've known him for about 6 years. And he just been blessed. He been blessing to me, man. He gave me an opportunity, man. And, you know, I knew once he gave me the opportunity, I wasn't going to let him down, you know. I have too much to prove. Even if, you know, I did good things in this league in the past, I played very great in this league in the past, I still have something to prove, man. Every time you go out there on the court, you have something to prove. And for me, every time I step on the court, I have something to prove to him for letting me have another opportunity, to my teammates for believing in me and giving me the basketball. You know what I'm saying? And just God, man, for giving me another opportunity just to be blessed, man.
Bien, le preguntamos qué se diría en lo de que si alguna estrategia tuviera que mejorar de su juego, ¿qué sería? Nos dice que ya no tendría nada que mejorar, simplemente sentirse agradecido una vez más de que Baker López le dio la oportunidad y de que conozcan mucho más de él y que se olviden de los rumores de que se habla sobre su persona. Y salir a jugar al ruedo como lo han hecho en los últimos días, que eso es lo que ha dado resultado para el club Huellas del Siglo. Finally, one last message you want to send to the Huellas del Siglo fans.
Man, God bless you. God bless you all. And I appreciate, and our team appreciates you coming out and supporting us, man. You know, my guy Henry, man, we've been playing against each other for years. You know, and we play hard against each other. We play duro against each other. So when I knew I was coming to his team, because he's the captain of the team, I knew I had to play hard for this team, man, because that's how he play, you know? So when he bring it like that, everybody got to bring the same intensity as him, man. So, you know, I just want the fans just to stay behind us, stay positive, man, and we're going to try to keep winning games.
Bien, le dice a la fanaticada de Huellas del Siglo que gracias por el apoyo, que Dios lo bendiga, y que jugadores... Agradece a jugadores también como Henry Valdez, que también lo ha motivado, lo ha atraído, lo ha recibido con los brazos abiertos y que van a salir a jugar duro al 100%. como lo han sabido hacer en los últimos partidos. One more time, thank Chris. Thanks, Chris. Really appreciate it and good luck.
Thank you, man. God bless, man.
Las palabras de Chris Moore, refuerzo de Huellas del Siglo para Pío Deportes.